The latest episode of the Clone Wars Season 7 was a short but action-packed one. The title was On the Wings of Keeradaks, and it's the third installment in the Bad Batch arc. We pick up right back on Skako Minor, with Anakin and the Bad Batch holding off waves of D-Wing battle droids, while Rex and Tech try to decrypt Echo's cerebral interface. Simply unplugging him could prove fatal. Due to this mission being unsanctioned by the Council, Anakin isn't able to call in reinforcements or an extraction, so they have to figure this entire mess out on their own. After a lot of destroying droids, the Bad Batch ends up soldering some doors shut to keep out the droids temporarily, and it's here that Wat Tambor finally shows up and he's flanked by hundreds of battle droids. Tambor orders that they send in the Decimator, which to me was this little droid ball of death, and apparently this was supposed to destroy organic matter or something along those lines, but as mentioned in my recent reviews, I have never watched the old showreels, so I have no frame of reference. Now, Tech finally cracks Echo's cerebral interface, allowing Rex to unplug him. Watching each hose come out of Echo's body was extremely reminiscent of Neo waking up in the real world in The Matrix. Plus, it continues this creepy sort of cosmic body horror vibe that Echo has going on. When Echo comes to, his first lucid interaction is to crack a joke to Rex, saying he's got a headache. And I like that. The bond of these brothers remains apparently fully intact. At least, it seems so. And Rex tells Echo that it's better to feel something than nothing at all. At this point, everyone is trapped inside of the stasis chamber lab, and due to Echo's unique situation, having been interfacing with all of Techno Union's data, he now knows everything and all means of escape. He's basically a living computer of sorts, now with a bit of a droid mech arm too. It's interesting. The Decimator droid cutting through the door was extremely reminiscent of Qui-Gon Jinn cutting through the blast doors in The Phantom Menace. And with this only minutes away from entering the room, Echo uses some of his droid parts like I mentioned to unlock the overhead exhaust vent, allowing them all to escape to safety. We watch Wrecker use his mutant strength, throwing everyone besides Anakin up into the exhaust vent. And I like that Anakin walked over to Wrecker like, nope, I got this, but thanks. I thought that was hilarious. Anakin also uses the Force to save Wrecker from the Decimator because he stayed behind to plant detonators all over the lab. This happens as Wat Tambor and friends gaze through the hole left by the Decimator to an empty room. They've been bested for now. Years of research is now lost, and Wat Tambor is not a happy individual. Now, as I mentioned, Echo has access to everything the Techno Union has due to being plugged into their system. And he leads them all to their only means of escape, which was walking across a pipe between two towers of the city. It has heavy Cloud City vibes. And I like that this kind of brought out the vulnerabilities again in the Bad Batch, at least with Wrecker, because we're kind of seeing his weakness, which is the fear of heights. It was funny in the last episode, so I like that they're continuing to show some of the flaws in these super tactical mutant clones. As you can expect, droids show up on either side of this pipeline, trapping everyone yet again. And someone yells out, "Anyone got a genius plan?" Tech was able to record the sounds of the Keeradaks and use that to call them to their aid so that they can fly away to safety. If that sounds familiar, it's probably because it reminds you of Frodo and Sam escaping Mordor on gigantic eagles. That's the vibe I got from this. It's a good vibe. I like it. And as they escape, the droids end up taking flight themselves. That's right, they fly now. The group makes their way back to the Politex village, and the fact that they tamed Keeradaks has greatly impressed the chief, but the fact that they are back concerns him. Immediately, some of those D-Wing droids drop blaster fire from overhead, demonstrating that the war has finally come to them. Neutrality is no longer an option, even though the original plan was to keep the natives out of this thing entirely. This angers the chief. Rex ends up showing the chief what the Techno Union did to one of his own, and I'd say that looking at Echo made the chief go, yikes. I don't want that, to be honest. So yeah, we will help you fight. From here on out, the rest of the episode is mostly this enormous, amazing ground battle. And yeah, it's really visually stunning. It's really fun to watch. Trench sent in droids to capture his experiment, as well as these gigantic tri-droids to flank both sides of this primitive village. Also, I like that exchange between Echo and Anakin before Anakin ends up taking on one of the walkers alone. I thought that was pretty great. It's showing us that Echo is kind of remembering more of who he is, at least that's my assumption of what's going on. A lot of things are coming back to him, he's back around his general, so all is seeming good. So in the end, Wat Tambor failed. Anakin, the Bad Batch, Rex, they all ended up defeating the droids. And the droids informed Tambor that they were unsuccessful. Tambor reflects that the loss of Echo is a devastating blow for the Techno Union, and specifically for its profit margins.
Wait, what? Politics and war profiteering in Star Wars? Oh my god.
For now, Tambor isn't ready to give out any of the information of what has just occurred on Skako Minor. And we cap off the episode with the Politech seeing the Bad Batch, Anakin and Rex, and Echo head off back to Anaxes. The Chief tells Anakin that the Jedi will always have an ally with the Politech, and Echo ends up thanking Rex for saving his life. And Rex says that it'll be just like old times. But then we linger on the decimated yet standing body of Echo. It's like he's thinking through something, or at least contemplating what has happened to him. Maybe it's just hitting him, and that's why we're slowly zooming into his face. For me, it kind of signifies something more ominous is on the horizon, but we shall see. So that does it for my recap of the episode. For those who have seen the showreels, did you think the final product was great? Did you not like it? Did you like it? I'm just curious. I've heard some murmurings of folks being upset over some omitted scenes, but for me, having no frame of reference for that, it wasn't a big deal. I really enjoy this episode, even if it was pretty much just action. And I'd also like to know what people think about what's going on with Echo. Part of me believes that he might still be compromised, somehow still connected to the Techno Union in some weird way, but it's hard to say. Either way, I like the message of no man left behind, on top of the concept of remaining neutral in the face of tyranny as an evil in and of itself. At the end of the day, you have to choose what to fight for. You can't just be a centrist or neutral all the time. And that's exactly what ended up happening with the Politechs, AKA the Star Wars Navi. So thank you for watching my recap and review. I will be continuing to review each episode as they come out, hopefully closer to the actual release date like today, but either way, I'm enjoying the Clone Wars Season 7. It's very strong so far. May the Force be with you, and AT-AT is signing off.